with the Philippine Senate Blue Ribbon Committee calling for the abolition of the Budget Department's procurement service. It is one of the recommendations in the panel's report on the probe into a controversial laptop purchase by the Education Department. The report said laptops procured by the PSDBM were underpowered and they were also overpriced by at least 979 million pesos. The committee also recommended the filing of charges against some former PSDBM personnel, including its former head, Christopher Lau, as well as DepEd officials. The investigation did not see any evidence to show former Education Secretary Leonor Briones should be held accountable for the fiasco.
Page 159 of the committee report would mention how the former secretary may have unwittingly approved the new parameters which increase the price and decrease the quantity of laptops to be purchased. Nagamit po siya sa wikang Tagalog.
Sir, pero yung legal liability, wala siya.
Sa ebidensya po lumabas, wala. Base po sa ebidensya. Iba po yung spekulasyon, iba po yung haka-haka, iba naman po yung lumabas sa hearing. Lahat po ng ginawa natin ay base po sa ebidensya at base po sa batas.
DepEd for its part says the agency will consider the recommendations of the Blue Ribbon Committee to make sure that its procurement processes are efficient and transparent. The agency also vows to cooperate should charges be filed against education officials.
DepEd will always cooperate kung meron mang proceedings that are going to take place in terms of if they need documentation on the side of DepEd.
The National Privacy Commission clears the full body and software provider Smartmatic of data privacy violations in connection to last year's elections. The case stemmed from allegations of election data breach. Under the ruling, while there was indeed a breach, the Commission on Elections is not mandated to notify the NPC about such an incident. The NPC recommended filing charges instead against former Smartmatic employee Ricardo Argana and a certain Winston Stewart for alleged involvement in the incident. Argana, whose laptop had access to Smartmatic's network, supposedly admitted providing Stewart his credentials in exchange for cash.
The Philippine Supreme Court First Division has granted temporary liberty to Gigi Reyes, the former chief of staff of former senator and now presidential legal counsel Juan Ponce Enrile. Reyes, who is facing plunder charges in connection with a multi-billion peso pork barrel scam, walked out of the Taguig City Jail on Thursday. This comes as the High Court granted Reyes's habeas corpus petition filed 2 years ago. The Supreme Court First Division justified its decision, saying that Reyes's confinement has become capricious and oppressive. The Supreme Court adds, Reyes was able to prove that her detention since 2014 had become an undue restraint on her liberty and a violation of her right to a speedy trial. Her temporary freedom, however, comes with conditions.
May mga condition po. Una, that Ms. Reyes shall personally attend the hearing. So may mga hearing pa po siyang aatendan sa criminal cases na filed sa kanya before Sandigan Bayan. And then pangalawa po, magsasubmit po ng quarterly periodic report to the clerk of court ng Sandigan Bayan ng kanyang whereabouts. So number three, magsisecure po siya ng travel authority from Sandigan Bayan in case po siya ay magbabiyahe. At number four, magsasubmit din po siya doon sa court through the Office of the Clerk of Court ng quarterly report ng compliance na doon sa mga kondisyon.
Suspended Prisons Chief Gerald Bantag won't be returning to office anytime soon. That's because Justice Secretary Jesus Renguia handed down another 90-day suspension order, this time for allowing convicted General Pito Palparan, who was serving time at the state penitentiary, a television interview in 2022. Bantag allegedly did not comply with proper procedures and guidelines. Bantag was first suspended by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. last October following the death of Bilibid inmate June Villamor, an alleged middleman in the killing of broadcaster Percy Lapi. The preventive suspension was set to expire on January 19th.